I'm a little nervous right now because tomorrow is going to be a very traumatic day. I am having my new passport photograph taken. I mean, and you never get it right, can you? I mean, like, for the next 10 years, I'm going to open these, obviously, to me. Is there anybody here that has a passport photo that's anywhere near normal? No. I mean, all the women look like Lulu. And all the blokes look like Mungo Jerry. I've got this passport photo. I've got a kip of time with a knot the size of Anglesey. And you have to show this when you go through passport control. And wherever you go throughout the world, passport control officers are always the same. I don't know, they have the most abysmal sense of humour. The millions of photos they must see, and every single time they open the photograph and they go... It is my contention that airports are more traumatic than flying. Right? Because when you get through passport control, what is the next port of call you go to? The conveyor belt with your luggage, if you're lucky. This is getting like Dunkirk now. I mean, it's right, isn't it? Everybody has to pack up, right, to the conveyor belt. Right there, because they've got to get their luggage first. No, you can't get in. No, get out. This is my space. This is my space. This is my building. Get out, get out. And have you ever seen a baggage handler? You look for them, don't you? You look for in that big square hole with all the dangly bits coming down. You try and spot a baggage handler. They're like the Yeti. They must exist. I mean, you know, you've seen their footprints in your luggage. And why is it that the biggest piece of luggage on the conveyor belt always belongs to some 95-year-old biddy in a wheelchair? He says, can anybody help? No. I'm trying to get my own bloody luggage. What's the matter? The last time I stuck her on the conveyor belt, you know. But for me, the most traumatic experience in an airport is to have to go through customs. Isn't that traumatic? I mean, don't you feel guilty? You're as clean as a whistle, but all you can think about is Midnight Express. And you can never remember how much you can take through. Is it 8 litres of still water or 4 litres? And it changes all over the world, wherever you go. I mean, the Middle East, you can't take any alcohol in whatsoever. And Mexico, you can't take avocados in. It's illegal to take avocados into Mexico. Like, I mean, you try putting one of them in a condom and swallowing it. I have real trouble going through these customs because I'm normally carrying a guitar, right? And if you carry a guitar through customs, forget it. I mean, you might just as well have a sign tattooed on your forehead, drugs baron, search my bottom. Every time they stop me, they ask the same stupid question. What's in the guitar case? You have to bite your tongue, you have to bite your tongue. The one time I said, a mouth organ. My feet never touched the ground. I was in this room, you know, and they sent a baggage handler in with a big latex rubber glove on his hand. But Birmingham Airport is the worst. I have to say that. If ever you go through the customs at Birmingham, they are red hot. Don't try anything. This summer, I came back. I bought a watch, right, in Spain, off a beach salesman. I must have been mental, but I did it. I mean, bit of sangria, I think. And I was lying on the beach, you know, with a towel over my toes, up to my nose here, and a nose guard on, you know, and a big hat and sun oil all over here. And he came up and he said, English? How they know I will not. So I said, what do you want? He said, would you like to buy a watch, you see? And I was a beach sound. Anyway, he was a brilliant beach sound. I have to say, he was brilliant. That's why I bought it. He sold it to me at 12 o'clock precisely. Brilliant. Because there's only one damn hand on the thing. So this cost me like 40,000 pesetas, this thing. So I'm coming into Birmingham, I'm going through the customs, and I thought, I'm not paying duty on this. I'm not paying duty, so I stuck it down my underpants. They'll never look there. Right, and when you go through customs, as you know, you look in any direction you can except at the customs man, correct? So I'm walking through with the trolley, and I didn't know that this watch had an alarm. And it was the birdie song. I'm walking through the green channel, and you can hear dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee. I thought, don't turn ahead, just look straight ahead and go. And I almost got away with it. Almost, I was almost through the green channel, and a bloke recognised me. He went, hey, Carrott! How you going, eh? Got the time on your cock?